The GVC, the Gunpowder Valley Conservancy, is about 20 years old at this point. It actually started in the Kingsville area and was concerned with local issues. We originally were concerned about trails, the condition of the local park. From there, it really grew to encompass all of the Gunpowder Valley Park.
The GVC's goals are to preserve the rural character of the land, the historic heritage, and the natural heritage in the watershed of the Gunpowder River. Well, this bridge is the logo of the Gunpowder Valley Conservancy. You'll see it on the masthead of our newsletters and on the return address of our envelopes. It's a bridge which represents, first of all, the history of the area. It's also a bridge which joins Baltimore County and Harford County, which the Gunpowder Watershed spans both those counties. It's a bridge over the Little Gunpowder Falls, a part of the Gunpowder River system. But in a more symbolic sense, the Conservancy itself is a bridge. The Conservancy is a grassroots organization. It grew up out of all the folks in this area wanting to be able to do something about conservation, but not really knowing how to do it.
We're concerned about water quality, we're concerned about reforestation, and we're very heavily involved in land preservation through the acquisition of easements.
In talking about the origins of the Conservancy, the very early days, our first really big project was a stream cleanup on the 20th anniversary of Earth Day. We got together with all kinds of organizations that could support us. We scouted out the Gunpowder Falls State Park streams and discovered areas with, in one place there was a Volkswagen upside down in the middle of a creek. We got the Maryland National Guard to join with us, a maintenance company out of Havre de Grace that had heavy, rough terrain equipment that could go into the woods and pull these things out. In 2 hours of work, well-organized work, we took something like 28 tons of trash out of the Gunpowder Watershed. And that was a major accomplishment. It got a lot of recognition. Even the governor, Governor Schaefer, was impressed with it. And it got us off to a really good start. We worked after that with Maryland Save Our Streams to adopt many, many streams in this watershed, to do routine cleaning of them, and to do routine assays about how healthy the streams were.
Well, the largest project is ongoing, and that's our involvement in the Rural Legacy Project that the state of Maryland sponsors. Through the Rural Legacy Program, we seek to restrict development, which not only helps the county in terms of its expenses, but preserves open space for the future. The easements are perpetual. It's not like zoning. It doesn't change. And hopefully it means that areas like this will be around for our children and grandchildren. The main thrust of getting citizen involvement has been through the schools and word of mouth. There is a, maybe not hardcore, but certainly a large group of people in Baltimore County who are of a similar mind. And the local community groups are also a great source of help, so that when we want to do a cleanup project or a reforestation project in a particular area, we will initially contact a community group, a school in the area, someone tied to that area who has a stake in the environment.
Our primary events are tree plantings, our stream watch program, Project Clean Stream, and our rain barrel and rain garden workshops. And with all of those events combined, we engage about 1,000 volunteers a year, and they make a direct impact on the environment by making a difference for future generations and on the health of the environment. In a little more specifically with our tree plantings, we do about 20 plantings a year, which is about 2,000 trees that we plant. That's about 10 acres of land that we plant each year, and that affects the air quality directly. For every acre of trees that we plant, which is 200 trees, it produces 4 tons of oxygen, and that's enough oxygen for 18 people to breathe. So multiply that times the year's efforts, so that's 180 people that can breathe, and it's 400 tons of oxygen produced Each acre also absorbs about 3,036 pounds of carbon dioxide. So that's a lot of carbon dioxide that's cleaned each year as well. So tremendously impacts the quality of the air. So the other impact that planting trees has is that it cleans the water quality. It improves the water quality, and that's because trees are a natural filter for the water. They filter out the nutrients like nitrogen and phosphorus, and nitrogen comes from lawn fertilizers, agricultural fertilizers, golf courses, which are right across the reservoir. And we've done a tremendous amount of plantings in the reservoir, so it filters the water naturally.
The most important thing is that we get trees done in a quality way. We don't want trees just thrown in the ground, so we want people to take their time. And most importantly, other than getting the tree in the ground properly, we want to make sure that everybody has fun and this is an educational experience as they're learning how to plant a tree, but most importantly, why. These trees are about a year old. We found that if the tree is properly put in the hole and we can pull the blue filament up, it exposes the root system and keeps it intact. We used to plant with seedlings. The problem there is you let the root system dry out and the tree dies before you even get it in the ground. This keeps the root system intact. The blue filament keeps voles from getting into the root system as well. And then it makes it easier to connect the shelter, which we have to put on because of the problem with deer and voles.
I think the most important thing for the Conservancy is to always be a living organization that is that bridge between all the opportunities to do conservation practices in Maryland and the people of the Gunpowder Watershed and the things they're interested in their own day and time.
It's wonderful to be able to make a difference every day with my work, especially when I'm out here with the volunteers and meeting new people and teaching young children and middle-aged people and elderly people, you know, about trees and why we plant them, and just being a part of this whole making a difference for the earth is extremely important to me. It's one of my goals in life, and being here at the GVC, I'm manifesting that.
The key to an organization is the staff and the passion that they bring to the organization. But I'm very optimistic because we have new board members coming on and we're going to get more enthusiasm for the work we're doing. So I'm very optimistic about GVC.